Welcome. In this video, we will show you how to install the stair nosing that we provide to create a beautiful, seamless vinyl stair covering for your staircase. We can create the nosing out of most click vinyl planks, and we encourage you to contact us to confirm that the vinyl that you would like to use on your stairs will work with our process. After verifying that your vinyl will work, you will need to cut each plank to the length of your stairs. Please start by cutting off the click on one side, then taking your measurements and making your final cut. After each cut, we encourage you to slide it onto the stair tread to ensure an accurate fit the way it would be installed. To make installation simple, many of our customers choose to flip the vinyl over and include a number to indicate which step it goes on. Just ensure you write it close to the side with the large click. Each stair may be a slightly different length. That is why we encourage that you do the cutting and test fitting at the location. You may also have a top step that is a slightly different length, and you want to account for that as well. Please also cut and provide two additional boards cut to the length of your longest step so we may verify the bend. Finally, you can choose either a round or square nosing shape. Then leave it to us to create your stair nosing. When installing your vinyl, you'll want to start at the bottom of your staircase and work your way up. So you'll start with the vertical riser. The height does not need to be exact as the top will be covered by the nosing. Measure the length and cut it from one piece of the additional flat vinyl. For this installation, you will need an industrial strength adhesive. Apply the adhesive to the back of the riser before setting it in place. You can use a chisel or any thin flat tool to press the vinyl down so it is flat and flush with the floor at the bottom. With the riser in place, you want to set your first piece of nosing in place on the step. You are then able to measure the remaining space to be able to cut a piece of flat vinyl to fill that space. Please take note of which direction the click is in to know which portion of the board to cut. While a table saw or even jigsaw will likely give you the most accurate cut, most vinyl can also be scored multiple times with a blade and then snapped to make the cut. Once you have your additional piece, you can use the click to attach it and create your full tread. We suggest you slide it in place to ensure the fit before applying your adhesive. When adding the adhesive, you can choose to either apply it to the back of the tread as demonstrated here, or putting it on the wood step first before sliding the tread into place. Ensure the tread is exactly where you want it, and then apply pressure to the top of all areas of the tread to ensure that the adhesive has made contact. You will then continue this exact process over and over with each step, adding adhesive to your risers and pressing them down to ensure a flush finish. After each riser is installed, you can set your next nosing in place, take your measurements, and cut your additional piece to ensure that each tread is the exact size that you need. You can then apply your adhesive and install, ensuring to add pressure. Continue this as many times as needed until all your stairs are covered. Your final step can be to add caulking along the edges of each of your steps. This creates a professional finish while also hiding any possible imperfections that may have occurred. Try to limit the use of the stairs for 12 hours to let the adhesive set, and then your stairs are ready for action.